From DocuSign, this is Developing with DocuSign. This episode is an introduction to OAuth for DocuSign developers. I'm Larry Kluger, a member of the DocuSign Dev Center team. In this screencast, I'll be focusing on API authentication. The same authentication techniques are used for virtually all of the DocuSign APIs. Signer authentication is also important for DocuSign applications. Signer authentication assures the sender that the signer or signers of your documents are who they say they are. DocuSign offers many types of built-in signer authentication that you can request for your envelopes, either via the DocuSign Web Tool or via API requests. Signer authentication options include the list shown on the screen and more. Our newest type of signer authentication is ID verification. With this feature, DocuSign will read and verify a scan of the signer's government-issued ID, such as a passport or driver's license. Please take a moment to subscribe to the DocuSign for Developers YouTube channel, and please also click the bell icon so you'll receive an email as we release new videos. Thank you. Let's focus in on API authentication. DocuSign's standard is OAuth, the Open Authentication Standard. OAuth enables your application to securely authenticate the user with DocuSign, even though your application will not see the user's password during the process. I'll show you how this works with a demo later on in the video. In addition to password security, OAuth provides the additional benefit that the authentication step is controlled by the DocuSign authentication server. This means, for example, that if a customer integrates a single sign-on system with the DocuSign authentication server, your application will also automatically support your customer's single sign-on system. In the same way, if a customer enables two-factor authentication, your application will support it automatically. Your goal for your app's authentication process is to obtain a DocuSign access token. Your application needs a token for every API call it makes to a DocuSign API provided by our cloud platforms. Please note that your application should be written defensively. There are multiple reasons why an access token can be refused by DocuSign. For example, a user withdrawing consent from your integration key. While it's possible for DocuSign to cancel an access token, that would only happen in an extraordinary circumstance. If a token is refused, then your application should discard it and create a new one. DocuSign supports three OAuth flows: Authorization Code Grant, JWT Grant, and Implicit Grant. The best OAuth flow to use is Authorization Code Grant. It is the easiest for the user and provides the best information security and security options. ISVs should especially try to use the Authorization Code Grant flow if they can. To use it, you will need the user to be present when your application is used or configured. Your application will also need a secure server component to protect the integration key's secret. If you can't use the Authorization Code Grant flow, then often the JWT flow, that is, the JSON Web Token flow, is the next best one to use, especially for system integrations where the user is not present. For single-page web applications or mobile applications where the user is present but there is no secure server component, use the Implicit Grant flow. We have code examples for multiple software languages for the different OAuth flows. They're available on GitHub and also discussed on the Dev Center. Before you can use your integration key to obtain an access token, you must obtain consent from the user. The authorization code and implicit grant flows will obtain consent from the user for your application the first time the user authenticates with your application. These flows provide a smooth user experience. Obtaining consent for JWT applications is a bit more complicated, and I'll discuss the options in the forthcoming JWT grant screencast. Now it's time for a quick demonstration of an application which uses the OAuth authentication code flow. Here's the web application. When I start the login process, my web browser is redirected to the DocuSign authentication server. First, I authenticate with the service via my name and password. Next, I'm asked to grant consent to the application, and now I'm returned to the application. Note that if my account starts to use two-factor authentication, single sign-on, or other authentication options, my application wouldn't need any changes to support the new security features. For our next demo, let's use the DocuSign Web Tool to see which applications I've granted consent to. We start with the DocuSign Web Tool, not with the Administration Tool. Note that I do not need to be a system administrator to use an externally provided application. Next, I open the profile screen and then choose the Connected Apps tab. Now I can see all of the apps I've granted consent to, and I can revoke consent from here as well. After your application has obtained an access token, there are a couple of additional steps before you're ready to make an API call. To make an API call, you also need the user's account ID and base URL. Use the OAuth User Info API call to obtain this information. The user's account or accounts and base URLs change very infrequently, so your application should cache the results for at least a day or until the user signs in again. Many OAuth authorization code grant libraries can automatically download the user's information. See the code examples on GitHub for more information. That's a wrap. Please subscribe to the channel and click the notification bell icon so you'll receive an email as we release new videos. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you on the next episode of Developing with DocuSign.